Hello students, today we are going to cover next topic of life processes, that is nutrition in animals. Let's start. In nutrition in animal, we will cover nutrition in amoeba and nutrition in human beings. So various in both amoeba and human being, nutrition is holozoic. What happen in holozoic nutrition? Complete food is taken and then it is digested. Various steps involved in the nutrition. First is ingestion. Ingestion, what is ingestion? It is taking in complex organic food through the mouth opening. In case of amoeba, this is not, mouth is not involved. But in case of human being, food is taken through the mouth opening. Then after taking in food is digested into the simple form, and this digestion into simple form is with the help of digestive enzyme. Third is, after the food is completely digested, it is absorbed through into the blood and lymph. So third step is the absorption. Absorption is the passing of simple soluble nutrients through food or through blood or lymph. Then food is completely absorbed. Then next step comes the utilization of this absorbed food. So next step is assimilation. It is the utilization of absorbed food for various metabolic processes like respiration. Then next is the egestion. Egestion, food is completely digested, absorbed, then the remaining waste material is expelled out of the body is the egestion. Next we will see nutrition in amoeba. See here, nutrition in amoeba. Amoeba is a unicellular organism and it lives in the water. Unicellular organism lives in water. How the amoeba take in food? It take in food by forming finger-like projection. See here, these finger-like projections are known as pseudopodia. Pseudo means false, podia means leg. So these false legs are known as pseudopodia. Amoeba take in food by forming finger-like projection called pseudopodia and form a food vacuole. With the help of this pseudopodia, amoeba form a food vacuole, see here. And inside the food vacuole, food is digested and then further it is absorbed. So, first of all, amoeba will form pseudopodia, just like this. This pseudopodia will be formed. Then this finger-like projection ingests the food material, suppose this is the food. And then it form a food vacuole, it will pinch off. And this food is digested with the help of digestive enzyme. Then undigested food is sent through the, removed out of the body by the process of ingestion. So first is ingestion, then digestion, third absorption, assimilation and egestion. Now we will see how the digestion process takes place in amoeba through a video. Nutrition in amoeba. We will see. We know that amoeba lives in the water and it eats tiny plants and animals present in the pond. These are pseudopodia. Amoeba take in food by extending arm-like structure. These are known as, see here, the food particle is coming and food particle reach when it reaches the near the amoeba. These pseudopodia then join and form a food vacuole. These are digested into smaller food particles inside the food vacuole with the help of digestive enzymes. Then the simple food is absorbed by the amoeba for assimilation. Undigested waste, these are simply thrown out of the body, and this process is known as egestion. The food vacuole will disappear. Now next we'll see nutrition in human being. Now nutrition in human being. Nutrition in human being takes place with the help of digestive system. Nutrition in human being takes place in the digestive system, and the human digestive system consists of alimentary canal first and second digestive juices, digestive glands which secrete digestive enzymes. So first is alimentary canal and second is digestive glands. Alimentary canal contains organ which start from the mouth and end to the anus. See here, this is the mouth and this is the anus, and the parts in between are alimentary canal starts from the mouth. Next to the mouth is esophagus. It is a pipe-like structure, see here, where through which food is transferred from mouth to the stomach. And in the esophagus there is the peristaltic movement. What is peristaltic movement? It is rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the esophagus. Then food is transferred to the stomach. In the stomach, where various gastric juices are present, food is further broken down. Then food then transferred to the small intestine. See here, in the small intestine, liver and pancreatic gland juices are released, and further breakdown of food material takes place in the smaller intestine. Then food passes to the large intestine. In the large intestine, there is absorption of various salts and water molecule. After the food digestion is completed, absorption is completed, it is transferred to the rectum, and efficacia takes place through the anus. So human digestive system, alimentary canal consists of mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine and large intestine. And various digestive glands are salivary glands present in the mouth and liver, which secrete bile, gallbladder which store the bile, pancreas which secrete pancreatic juices. So alimentary canal consists of mouth, esophagus, stomach, small intestine, large intestine and anus. And digestive glands are consisting of salivary glands, gastric glands present in the stomach, liver, pancreas and intestinal glands. So this is the mechanism of digestion. We will see another video of digestion in human beings. How the food is digested. Digestion in human being. Digestion starts with the mouth. We take the food. See here, food, how the food passes through the esophagus, then food reaches the stomach. This is the large intestine. See here, this is epiglottis, which These are the parts of alimentary canal. These are various salivary glands present in the mouth. Liver is also a gland. This is pancreas. Now, mouth and buccal cavity. When we take in food, it is masticated by the teeth. Mastication means broken down of large food into smaller particles by the chewing of teeth. This food is masticated into simpler form. Action of saliva. Saliva contains salivary amylases, which helps in the breakdown of carbohydrates present, sugar present in the saliva. Saliva converts starch in the food into sugar, and it also softens the food. Then what is the function of tongue? Tongue contain taste buds. This digested food is known as bolus. In the mouth, masticated food is known as bolus. Then it is transferred to the esophagus. See here, the structure epiglottis prevent the transfer of food into the respiratory pathway. Then the food is transferred through the esophagus to the stomach. In the stomach, various digestive juices are secreted by gastric glands. Pepsin is secreted here, which helps in the breakdown of protein molecule, and this food then transfer to the small intestine. See here how the food is broken down into smaller particles. This is the duodenum, first part of small intestine. The small intestine is the largest part of alimentary canal, and it is overcoiled. In the small intestine, secretion from the liver and pancreas mixed. Liver is the largest gland in human body, and it secretes bile. And this bile is further stored into the gallbladder. Pancreas, it is a gland present below the stomach. See here, it is present below the stomach. And it secretes its juices into the first part of small intestine. It acts on the digested food coming from the mouth, coming from the stomach. This is the food digestion in the small intestine. Food consumed is digested, and now it is ready to be absorbed to the blood. Now the food will be absorbed to the small intestine. See here, in the small intestine, various finger-like projection called villi are present. And these villi contain, we will see the internal structure of these villi. They have blood and lymph. Blood capillaries and lymphatic vessels will absorb the simple digested food, and this is then absorbed to the blood, travel to the throughout the body with the help of blood. And when they reaches the particular organs, the undigested and unabsorbed food enter the large intestine. In the small intestine, food is completely absorbed. Then remaining waste material is then reaches the large intestine. Here the absorption of water and salt take place. Keep in mind, in the large intestine, water and salt absorption takes place. This undigested food then stored into the rectum and efficated through the anus. So this was all about the digestion in human being. So let's cover. Human digestion begin from the mouth. Okay, in the mouth it is broken down by the salivary amylase. Salivary amylase is secreted by the salivary glands, which are present in the mouth. Then food moves to the stomach through the esophagus. When the food is digested in the mouth, food is masticated in the mouth and it is broken down into smaller particles. This food is known as bolus. This bolus now travel from mouth to the stomach through the esophagus. And in the esophagus, there is peristaltic movement. What is peristaltic movement? It is the rhythmic contraction and relaxation. See here, this is the esophagus and this is the stomach. This bolus is transferred from mouth to the stomach through the various peristaltic motion of the esophagus. See here, when the food is present here, there is contraction from the upper part and then this bolus moves down. So there is rhythmic contraction and relaxation of the esophagus. Finally, food reaches the stomach. Enzymes and various digestive juices from the liver and gallbladder, and pancreas act on the chunks from the stomach. In the stomach, various digestive juices like pepsin and HCl, they break down food material further. Then it is transferred to the intestine. In the intestine, there is secretion of gallbladder and pancreas. These juices further break down the food in the smaller intestine. In the large intestine, the remaining nutrients are absorbed and leftover are removed from the body through the rectum and anus. Now we will see the summary, whole summary of the human digestive system in a flow chart. First is the mouth. In the mouth, salivary gland secrete saliva. Saliva contains salivary amylase. What is the function of saliva? What is the function of salivary amylase? It convert starch into the sugar. Now in the mouth, teeth and tongue are present. What is the function of teeth? Chewing of food. What is the function of tongue? Rolling and tasting of food. Then comes the second organ, that is esophagus. Esophagus take food from mouth to the stomach. Here will come the stomach. Mouth to the stomach by peristaltic मूवमेंट, यहाँ पे आप स्टमक कर लेना, यहाँ इसोफेगस नहीं आएगा, माउथ टू द स्टमक बाय पेरिस्टाल्टिक मूवमेंट. सो द वट इज द पेरिस्टाल्टिक मूवमेंट, रिदमिक कॉन्ट्रेक्शन एंड एक्सपेंशन ऑफ एलिमेंट्री केनाल. थर्ड ऑर्गन इज द स्टमक. स्टमक कंटेन्स वेरियस गैस्ट्रिक जूसेस एंड दीज गैस्ट्रिक जूसेस आर पेप्सिन, HCl एंड म्यूकस. तो ये बहुत वन मार्क्स में क्वेश्चन पूछा जाता है, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ म्यूकस, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ पेप्सिन, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ HCl. सो वी नो दैट HCl केमिस्ट्री लैब में आप जाके HCl का pH चेक करना, HCl का pH होता है 1.8. अब इतने कम pH पे हमारे स्टमक की वॉल, इंटरनल वॉल्स जो होती हैं वो बहुत ही सॉफ्ट होती हैं, और pH यहाँ पे देखो 1.8 है. इतनी लो pH पे हमारे स्टमक की वॉल्स बर्न हो सकती हैं. उस बर्निंग को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए हमारे स्टमक के अंदर एक लाइनिंग होती है म्यूकस की. सो म्यूकस हेल्प्स इन द प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ इनर लाइनिंग ऑफ स्टमक. किससे प्रोटेक्शन कर रहा है ये? HCl से. ठीक है, सो व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ म्यूकस? इट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट. सो फंक्शन ऑफ म्यूकस इज प्रोटेक्शन ऑफ इनर लाइनिंग ऑफ स्टमक फ्रॉम द HCl. ओके, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ पेप्सिन? पेप्सिन ब्रेक डाउन द प्रोटीन. प्रोटीन के ब्रेकडाउन में कौन हेल्प करेगा? पेप्सिन. ओके, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ HCl? अब ये पेप्सिन है ये सिर्फ एसिडिक pH पे ही काम करता है, और वो एसिडिक pH कौन मेंटेन करता है? HCl. सो व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ HCl? इट मेक द मीडियम एसिडिक. नेक्स्ट कम्स द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन. इन द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन सिक्रीशन फ्रॉम द लीवर एंड पैनक्रियास रीचेस फ्रॉम द लीवर, लीवर सिक्रेट बाइल, पैनक्रियास सिक्रेट पैनक्रियाटिक जूसेस. हम यहाँ पे देख लेते हैं, व्हाट इज द फंक्शन ऑफ बाइल? बाइल फंक्शन इज इमल्सिफिकेशन. अब यहाँ पे इमल्सिफिकेशन वन मार्क्स में कई बार क्वेश्चन पूछ लेते हैं, व्हाट इज इमल्सिफिकेशन? इमल्सिफिकेशन इज द ब्रेकडाउन ऑफ लार्ज फैट ग्लोब्यूल इनटू द स्मॉलर फैट ग्लोब्यूल्स. यहाँ पे देखिए, ये लार्ज फैट का ग्लोब्यूल है, इसको अगर सिंपलर सिंपलर फैट के ग्लोब्यूल्स में ब्रेक डाउन करेंगे, दैट प्रोसेस इज नोन एज इमल्सिफिकेशन. अब यहाँ पे आपको माइंड में रखना है कि बाइल के अंदर कोई एंजाइम नहीं होता. कीप इन माइंड, इन द बाइल देयर इज नो एंजाइम. तो बाइल फिर एक्ट कैसे करता है? बाइल फैट के लार्ज मॉलिक्यूल को स्मॉलर मॉलिक्यूल में ब्रेक डाउन करता है, एंड दिस प्रोसेस इज द इमल्सिफिकेशन. तो यहाँ पे कोई डाइजेशन नहीं हो रहा है, यहाँ पे सिर्फ इमल्सिफिकेशन हो रहा है. देन पैनक्रियाटिक जूसेस. पैनक्रियाटिक जूसेस कंटेन्स ट्रिप्सिन एंड लाइपेसिस. तो ट्रिप्सिन का फंक्शन क्या होता है? प्रोटीन को स्मॉलर मॉलिक्यूल्स में ब्रेक डाउन करना, एंड दीज आर पेप्टोन्स. एंड द लाइपेज फंक्शन इज, ये जो इमल्सिफाइड फैट था, स्मॉल फैट के ग्लोब्यूल्स थे जो लीवर के बाइल जूस से ब्रेक डाउन हुए थे, स्मॉलर फैट ग्लोब्यूल्स, इन पे अब लाइपेजेस एक्ट करेंगे, एंड लाइपेजेस कन्वर्ट इमल्सिफाइड फैट इंटू फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल. ठीक है, नाउ कम्स द फंक्शन ऑफ इंटेस्टाइनल जूसेस. इंटेस्टाइनल जूसेस कंप्लीट ब्रेक डाउन करते हैं फूड का. सो फूड कंटेन्स कार्बोहाइड्रेट फैट्स एंड प्रोटीन, तीन ही लार्ज कंपोनेंट होते हैं हमारे फूड में. इंटेस्टाइनल जूसेस एक्ट ऑन द कार्बोहाइड्रेट और उसको किस में कन्वर्ट कर देते हैं? ग्लूकोज में. दे एक्ट ऑन द फैट एंड कन्वर्ट इट इंटू फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल. दे एक्ट ऑन प्रोटीन एंड फॉर्म अमाइनो एसिड्स. तो यहाँ पे आप देखिए, स्मॉलर जो सिंपल एब्जॉर्बेबल मॉलिक्यूल्स जो फॉर्म हुए वो क्या क्या हैं, ग्लूकोज, फैटी एसिड ग्लिसरॉल एंड अमाइनो एसिड्स। ठीक है, ये समरी बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, लर्न कर लेना। देन लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन, लार्ज इंटेस्टाइन का फंक्शन क्या होगा, एब्जॉर्ब एक्सेस वाटर। देन रेक्टम, रेक्टम एक्ट एज ए टेम्पोरेरी कलेक्शन ऑफ वेस्ट मटीरियल। देन एनस हेल्प्स इन द इजेशन। एक बार फिर से रिवाइज कर लेते हैं। माउथ कंटेन सलाइवरी अमाइलेज विच कन्वर्ट स्टार्च इंटू शुगर। देन कम्स द इसोफेगस, हेयर पेरिस्टेलेटिक मूवमेंट टेक्स प्लेस। देन कम्स द स्टमक, स्टमक सीक्रेट वेरियस गैस्ट्रिक जूसेस, गैस्ट्रिक जूसेस कंटेन्स पेप्सिन HCl एंड म्यूकस। म्यूकस प्रोटेक्ट द वॉल ऑफ स्टमक एंड HCl प्रोवाइड एसिडिक मीडियम फॉर द एक्शन ऑफ पेप्सिन एंड पेप्सिन ब्रेक डाउन सिंपल ब्रेक डाउन प्रोटीन मॉलिक्यूल्स। देन कम्स द स्मॉल इंटेस्टाइन, सीक्रेट लीवर, सीक्रेट बाइल एंड पेनक्रेटिक जूस। बाइल हेल्प्स इन द इमल्सिफिकेशन, पेनक्रेटिक जूस कंटेन ट्रिप्सिन एंड लाइपेजिस। ट्रिप्सिन ब्रेक डाउन प्रोटीन इंटू पेप्टोन एंड लाइपेजिस कन्वर्ट फैट इंटू फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल। देन इंटेस्टाइनल जूसिस, दे कॉज द कंप्लीट ब्रेक डाउन ऑफ फूड इंटू ग्लूकोज, अमाइनो एसिड्स, फैटी एसिड एंड ग्लिसरॉल। सो दिस वॉज ऑल अबाउट ह्यूमन डाइजेस्टिव सिस्टम।